bright Pleiades. It's so strange what his distant eye sees. Who knows why you start rediscovering your heart, but you do it again and again. How's everybody doing? It is so cool. It is so cool to come back to Willow Valley. So it seems like only yesterday I was looking out that window, and here we are back again, looking out that window again. So I was just saying to Kelsey, the last time I was here was over at the Vistas. We were up on the roof, which was so cool. So it's nice here. It's nice here at Willow Valley. I like it a lot. So glad to be back. So, they brought me in to do Jimmy Buffett music, and I've had a relationship with Jimmy Buffett's music for 40 years, and it is an incredible loss to have such a talent and inspiration. I mean, the pioneer of escapism, you know, but. I believe that Jimmy's in a better place at this point, so I'm going to play Buffett tunes, and what I figured I would do is I'm going to start back with his first album, because everybody knows Margaritaville, and everybody knows Cheeseburger in Paradise and Fins, and people don't realize that before Margaritaville hit, Jimmy was a great songwriter, and there's a whole lot of great singer-songwriter music that was on those previous albums. So I went through my song list of Buffett stuff, and I want to work through it chronologically. So we're going back to 1973. And his first commercial album was an album called A White Sport Coat and a Pink Crustacean. So he was already establishing himself pretty well as a humorist. And this is one of my favorite Jimmy Buffett songs. It's on that album. The song's called He Went to Paris, and it's about living a good life. So I hope that you enjoy this as much as I'm going to enjoy singing it for you. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. Warm summer breezes and French wines and cheeses, put his ambitions at bay. Summers and winters scattered like splinters, and 4 or 5 years slipped away. He went to England, played the piano, married an actress named Kim. He had a good life, she was a good wife, and bore him a young son named Jim. All of the answers and all of the questions locked in his attic one day. He liked the quiet, cool country living, and 20 more years slipped away. His lady left him with only one eye. His body was battered, his whole world was shattered. All he could do was just cry. As tears were falling, he was recalled. Answers he never found. So he hopped on a freighter, skated the ocean, and left England without a sound. Drinks his green label each day, writing his memoirs, losing his hearing, but he don't care what most people say. After 86 years of perpetual motion, if he likes you, he'll smile and he'll say, Jim is some of its magic, some of it's tragic, but I had a good life all the way. Looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He went to Paris. Jimmy Buffett. Thank you very much. Well, right off of that same album, Jimmy had a great way of telling stories about the way things used to be. So here's one about drive-in movies. You guys will remember this one. This one's actually also on the Songs You Know by Heart, which became like the standard of Jimmy Buffett songs to know. The song's called Grapefruit Juicy Fruit. Thank you. wash away the night. Chew delicious fruit, it's good for the soul. Grapefruit juice. Isn't that a great tune? Switch guitars for this one because it sounds so much better on this guitar. This is a nylon string guitar. It's got a softer tone to it. Guys like Zach Brown and Willie Nelson use this guitar, so I figured I'd bring it along. Now this next song also, yeah, I'm still in 1973, folks, and we're still on the White Sport Coat album. And the gentleman who wrote this song for Jimmy, this guy by the name of Tom Corcoran. And actually, that guitar I was just playing over there was owned by Tom Corcoran. I've known Tom. Tom passed away a couple years back. And boy, Tom had the stories. I mean, the early days of Jimmy Buffett's career and the stories that he would tell about hanging out with the Eagles and hanging out with Jack Nicholson. And, you know, Jimmy Buffett had a great life. But this one Tom wrote was about going over to Cuba. The song's called Cuban Crime of Passion. There was a piano player up from Miami Way. He could play in the bars, he could sound like the stars. Women would pay and pay. One night he did wind up playing in a band of town. Nobody knew, at least Billy Voltaire, these were his final sounds. As he met up with Marita, from the coast, half woman, half child, she drunk and half wild. He loved that lady the most. One night he did find her in the arms of Shrimper Dan. Then it took a night to go down his life, then he turned his old cold hand. And it's just a Cuban crime of passion, lesson and old fashioned. What the papers did say, it's just a Cuban crime of passion, añejo and eyes slashing. That's what the people like to read about up in America, up in America. Say she got ill. Billy Voltaire, no one would claim him. He was buried on Bobber's Hill. Nobody talks about it no more. It happened just a week ago. But people get by and people get high in the tropics. They come and they go. And it's just a human crime passion, messy and old-fashioned. What the papers did say, it's just a Cuban crime of passion, añejo and eyes flashing. That's what the people like to read about up in America, up in America, up in America, up in America. Thank you. Crime of Passion. I love that song. Now I play with the Jimmy Buffett tribute band. As a matter of fact, this weekend we'll be doing a concert down in Salisbury, Maryland at the Civic Center. And there I get to play lead guitar. Now the tough thing is that, you know, playing solo, I don't get to do any of the cool leads. There's this real cool lead. I don't get to do that. I got to play the chords, you know. So I had to throw that in there before I put the guitar back down. So after doing Tom's song, we might as well get Tom's guitar back in. Now this next song is my first introduction to Jimmy Buffett. I don't think it lasted too long on the radio or on the charts too well, but it lasted forever in jukeboxes across the bars of the United States, and I'm sure around the world, because this became, I mean, and now keep in mind, this is 1973, and Changes in Latitudes didn't come out till like 1977, so nobody knew who Jimmy Buffett was at this time, but there'd be this song playing on the jukebox that I am sure is responsible for many of the next generation of children. I used to play in a country band when I first heard this. And I'll tell you, it's a great opening line. Well, I really do appreciate fact that you're sitting here. Your voice just sounds so wonderful, but your face don't look too clear. So I may bring a pitcher, another round of brew. Honey, why don't we get drunk and screw? Don't we get drunk and screwed? I just bought me a waterbed filled up for me and you. They say you are a snow queen, honey. I don't think that's true. So why don't we get drunk and screwed? Instrumental refrain. Of course, he only wrote one verse for this song. With a song like this, you really only need one verse. So we'll just play it around till we get to the chorus. Remember, Jimmy Buffett was the father of politically incorrect. Tell you, that song was ingrained upon my memory much deeper than Margaritaville was when it came out. I've always said, if you're a Jimmy Buffett fan, you're going to remember who you were with when you first heard a particular song, you know, and it's like you make the connection, and one of the great things about Jimmy's music is that you can hear the tune, you know, you hear the tune on the radio. And wherever you were, it takes you right back. Like the first time you heard, like, Come Monday, the first time you heard Pirate Looks at 40 or something, takes you right back to that time. That's the sign of timeless songwriting, and that was, that's what Jimmy was all about. I'm going to do one more song from the White Sport Coat album. And again, this was before Margaritaville, before anybody knew who he was. There was an interview with Bob Dylan, and they asked Bob Dylan what his favorite song was at the time. And he said, well, you know, there's so many great songwriters out there, but he said there's a new up-and-coming songwriter, a guy by the name of Jimmy Buffett, wrote this song, and he said, I think he's got quite a future. And the song that it was Bob Dylan's favorite song is a song called Death of an Unpopular Poet. So this is also one of my favorite tunes. I used to play with a guy by the name of John Frenzy, and John would always get up and play this particular song. There were a number of songs that he played by himself, and the band didn't play along on. And it's like, I always loved this tune. So at one point, I decided I got to sit down and learn this tune. So I sat down. I was down in Key West at my buddy Yankee Jack's place, and in his backyard, I sat down and I listened to this to work the tune out. And it was the first time that I really let the song sink in. And I tell you, I cried for about a half an hour. I mean, it's just such a beautiful song. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this. This is called Death of an Unpopular Poet. I once knew a poet. Lived before his time. He and his dog Spruce listened while he'd rhyme. Songs to make you happy, words to make you cry. Then one day the boat suddenly did die. Left behind the closet filled with verse and rhyme. By some strange transaction, one was printed in the Times. Everybody's searching for the king of underground. They found him down in Florida, tombstone for a crown. Everybody knows rhymes from his books that cost $4.99. I wonder if he knows he's doing quite this fine. 'Cause his books are all bestsellers, his poems turn to song. Got his brother on a talk show, though they never got along. Now he's called immortal, and he's even taught in school. They say he used his talent, it's the most proficient tool. He left all of his royalties, schooner his old hound, growing old on steak and bacon in a doghouse 10 feet round. Everybody wonders, did he really lose his mind? No, he was just a poet who lived before his time. Was just a poet who lived before his time. Isn't that a great song? That's the kind of songwriter that Jimmy Buffett was. So that was 1973. Now we're going to go to 1974. And Jimmy was putting out albums, at least trying to get them out like once a year. And so on this one, He had, recorded the song. It was originally written by Jerry Jeff Walker, and it's a great song again. Great song about Jimmy Buffett. It's called Stories We Could Tell. Because as musicians, we don't do it for the money. We used to do it for the chicks. Now we just do it for the stories. Talking to myself again, wondering if this traveling is good. There's something else doing we'd be doing if we could. Oh, the stories we could tell. Before it all blows up and goes to hell. Wish that we could sit back on a bed in some hotel. Laugh about those stories we could tell. Stared at that guitar in that museum in Tennessee. Name upon a faceplate took back many memories. Scars upon his face told of every time he fell. Singing all the stories he could tell. Old stories he could tell. Bet you it still rings like a bell. I wish that we could sit back on a bed in some hotel. Laugh about those stories we could tell. Chasing down your every night, playing for a living neath the brightly colored lights. If you ever wonder why we ride this carousel, do it for the stories we could tell. Oh, the stories we could tell. Before we have to say our last farewell. Wish that we could sit back on a bed in some hotel. Laugh about those stories we could tell. Yeah, I wish we could sit back on a bed in some hotel. Laugh about those stories we could tell.
Oh, yeah.
Jimmy Buffett recorded. Jerry Jeff wrote it. Great tune. So, here's another one of my personal favorites. That, I mean, years and years of Jimmy Buffett music, you don't have, like, one favorite. You just got, like, a whole bunch of them, and you just, it's the way you feel on a given day. So, I got a great story that goes with this. Is that how many people have been to Key West, Florida? We got Key West travelers, all right? Way back, this would have been back in 1992, I was down there playing on the gambling boat called the Atlantic X. And what would happen is that boat would sail out of Key West Seaport at sundown, and they'd have a musician on the deck playing music to get us out into international waters. And then we'd go out in the international waters, and they would gamble. And then I'd be playing up there all by myself because everybody was down there gambling. It would be just me and whoever, like, already lost all their money and was up there with me. And then after that was done, then I'd play them back in, and we'd sail back into Key West. And one of my favorite memories was being up there on the deck. I think there were, like, two people that I was playing to. And I'm playing A Pirate Looks at 40, and I'm thinking, here I am on a boat in the middle of the ocean, looking out, and in the distance I can see Key West, and I'm singing A Pirate Looks at 40. It's like one of those moments you just want to last forever. So if this is your favorite song, I hope that you enjoy it as much. Thank you. Mother, Mother Ocean, I have heard you call. I wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the man who rode you switch from sails to steam. In your belly you could hold the treasures you have ever seen. Most of them dreams. Most of them dreams. Yes, I am a pirate. 200 years too. Victim of fate, arriving too late, arriving too late. I done a bit of smuggling, I run my share of grass, made enough money to buy Willow Valley, but I pissed it away so fast, never meant to last. Never meant to last. Well, I've been drunk now for over 2 weeks. Passed out in a rally dance from a few leaks. I gotta stop wishing, gotta go fishing. Down the rock bottom again. Just a few friends. Just a few friends. It's always good to have your friends around. Sweat's starting to come out. Pretty soon we'll have the Elvis thing happening. So here's another great song about Key West. The thing about Key West is, man, is as soon as you get back home, the first thing you want to do is you want to turn around and go right back down there. So the story, this song was written about the days when he and Jerry Jeff introduced Jimmy to Key West, Florida, and they used to drive his Packard down A1A, down to get down to the end of the line. And that's what this song's about. It's called Tin Cup Chalice. I want to go back to the islands where shrimp boats tie up to the pilot. Give me oysters and beer, Virginia every night of the year. I feel fine, I feel fine. gonna go back down and lie beside the sea there. We'll take a four chance, fill it up with good red wine, and I'll bet you on a honeysuckle vine. Yeah, the sun goes gliding across the water. Sailboats, they go searching for the breeze. Salt air, it ain't thin. It'll stick right to your skin. Makes you feel fine. Makes you feel fine. 'Cause I wanna be there. Wanna go back down and get high by the sea there. We'll take a four chalice, fill it up with good red wine, and I'll bet you on a honeysuckle vine. And now you heard my strange proposal. Won't you get that Packard running and let's go? I wanna be there before the day tries to steal away, leave us behind. I made up my mind. 'Cause I wanna be there. Red wine, and I'll be chewing on a honeysuckle vine. Say, yeah, we'll tinker for chalice. Fill it up, good red wine, and I'll be chewing on a honeysuckle vine. Thank you very much. So we're still in 1974. The album is called A1A. And then this is the year that Jimmy had his first commercial hit. So before, long before Margaritaville came out, a song about hush puppies and Labor Day. This is called Come Monday. Up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I've got my hush puppies on. Guess it never was meant for glitter, rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. And come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown alley haze, and I just want you back by my side. So yes, it's been quite a summer, rent a cars and westbound trains. Now you're off on vacation. Not too hard to explain. Honey, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just had to go. And come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown alley haze, and I just want you back by my side. Help it, honey. You're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana? You said there'd be no room for doubt. And then came Doyle Grisham's incredible solo. hope you're enjoying the scenery. I hear that it's pretty out there, so we could go hiking on Tuesday. With you, I would walk anywhere. California has warmed me quite thin. It's so nice to be at Willow Valley again. And come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I've been four lonely days in a brown and a haze, and I just want you back by my side. Just want you back by my side, by my side. Come Monday. That's still got to be like all the way up there at the top. That's one of those songs, man. You hear that come on, if you're at a 7-Eleven and it comes on the radio, you're gonna walk up and down the aisles until that song's over. You're not leaving. I mentioned about John Frenzy, and John Frenzy was a songwriter. Boy, he still is a songwriter. He lives now living down in Florida. Was a very good friend of mine, and I played on his band, and he got picked up by Doyle Grisham. Doyle Grisham is the pedal steel guitar player that played with the Coral Reefers with Jimmy Buffett. And so I had this opportunity many times to play with Doyle and also with Mike Utley and Robert Greenwich. And I'll tell you, playing Come Monday with the guy that did the solo playing it right there, you know, it's like, oh yeah. I may be a musician, but I'm still a fan deep down inside, man. It's like, yeah, go Doyle, go. So beautiful stuff, beautiful stuff. We're going to do one more song from A1A. We're going to take a trip on down to New Orleans. This song's called The Wino and I Know. The Ice Cream Man is a hillbilly fan. 78's by Hank Snow. Walks down the street, shuffling his feet to a rhythm that only he knows. So many places. He was there on the night I was born. In Bourbon Street Bar, see my first scar from an old man so tattered and torn. Wino and I Know, the paint's back busting like a farmer knows the pains of his pickup truck rust. Strange situation, wild occupations, living my life like a song. That excite me, be the pastry or lobsters or love. I'm just trying to get by, being quiet and shy in a world full of pushing and shoving. I know when I know the paint the street singing like door salesman knows the paint the bell ringing. Strange situations and wild occupations, living my life like a song. Oh yeah, the Wino and I Know. Now we go from 1974. Next album to come out was 1976. That was the year that I graduated from high school. And Jimmy was already making money, so I'm gonna check the tuning on this. It sounds a little funky here. But I got two songs that I do off of that particular album. The first one's going to take us, of course, back down into Key West. Played the bull down on Caroline Street. A guy by the name of Yankee Jack up until about 2016. It was so great to sing A Woman Gone Crazy on Caroline Street, on Duval and Caroline Street. There's a woman gone crazy on Caroline Street, asking every man she does meet, saying if you be gentle, if you be sweet, place on Caroline Street. She claims in a loud voice to be a dancer, but I don't think she's cut a rug in years. She listens to the jukebox for dancers, slowly guzzles 25-cent beers. The men she's known and that some she's seen them in her dreams and on the street. She slides her dapper legs from beneath the table as if to reveal some kind of treat. Woman gone crazy on Caroline Street, stopping every man she does meet, saying if you be gentle, on Caroline Street. Lover left stranded in Jamaica. Just right now she can't call his name. On the street and in bedrooms, and all those lurking eyes, they look the same. Shrimpers in a frenzy, horny and don't need a good excuse. Someone yells and things just start erupting. In a flash, all hell has broken loose. There's a woman gone crazy on Caroline Street, stopping every man that she does meet, saying if you be gentle, if you be sweet, I'll show you my place on Caroline Street. I woke up, looked across the barroom. She was gone and I was black and blue. So be careful when you go to swing your partner. Someone just might take a swing at you. There's a woman gone crazy on Caroline Street, stopping every man she does meet, saying if you be gentle, if you be sweet, I'll show you my place on Caroline Street. There's a woman gone crazy on Caroline Street, stopping every man she does meet, saying if you be gentle, if you be sweet, show you my place on Caroline Street. Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. These are the Jimmy Buffett deep cuts. You'll hear these songs like once every 10 years, you know? But it's great to dig some of this stuff out. So, are you guys having a good time? We doing all right out there? Everybody all right? I'm having fun up here, but I don't want to be the only one having fun. So, I'm hoping that you guys. I figured I'd make this like educational. You know, it's sort of like a Jimmy Buffett documentary. What's that?
As long as there's no test.
There's no test. The only test is whether you can still walk after you drink all the margaritas, you know. And what is your name, sir?
Mike.
Mike?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'd like to thank Mike. Mike gave us the little production up here on the stage. So thank you, Mike. How about a hand for Mike?
We're
give him Mike.
Karaoke tomorrow night?
At the plaza. Okay, karaoke tomorrow night.
The bar will be open.
Okay, you can do all these Jimmy Buffett tunes tomorrow with the words flashed up right in front of you. So, I'll bet you will, Mike. So, good deal, man. No shirt, no shoes, no problem. But I promised I would do all Jimmy Buffett songs, so we'll save the Kenny Chesney for the next time, you know? So the song I was talking, the album I was talking about here from 1976 was called Havana Daydreaming. This is the title song to that track, another one of my favorite tunes. And you can just picture 90 miles south of Key West, Florida, going into Havana. Stash his trash in Ecuador, bought a good suit of clothes, flew on out to Mexico, standing by the shore, waiting on some mystery men to pay him for his time, thinking about all the money he made. Couldn't help to ease his mind, Havana daydreaming. Boy, he's just scheming his life away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Daddy chops that sugar cane. One day he failed. Jesus had a wandering feeling spinning around in his head, sailing on a midnight boat. There were no questions asked. Air was so clean and the water so green, he just stuck right to his task of vanity dreaming. Boy, he's just scheming his life away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ceiling fan stirred the air. That cigar smoke get to swirl. Fragrance on a pillowcase in hell. Think about the girl. Spilling wine, sharing good times. He sure could make him smile. Pays her well, but what the hell? He'll be moving in a little while. Vanity dream. Boy, he's just scheming his life away. Havana daydreaming. Boy, he's just scheming his life away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Havana daydreaming. much. That was 1976. And then the world changed. 1977 came out. An album. Oops, this thing is still sounding. This thing sounding a little funky here. I have to adjust my G string. I'm serious. It is. It's the G string. There. That's me. So, those of you with perfect pitch, I'm sure that last song was driving you crazy. So, sorry about that. So, this album called Changes in Latitudes came out. So here's the title track from Changes in Latitudes, but you know what's coming up. Giving up. Getting ahead of myself. I took off for a weekend last month. Try and recall the whole year, all the places and all the faces I want where they all disappear. Well, I didn't ponder the question too long. Got hungry, went out for a bite. I ran into a chum with a bottle of rum. We wound up drinking all night. Remind me of the places I've been. Visions of good times that brought so much pleasure. I wish I could go back again. If it suddenly ended tomorrow, I could somehow just do the work. Help me out. Good times and riches and... Oh, come on. It's all right to say it once. It's good times and riches and I've seen more than I can recall. Changes in latitudes, changes in attitudes, and nothing remains quite the same. All of the islands and all of the highlands, if I couldn't laugh, I just would go insane. Wish I was sailing again, but yesterday's over my shoulder, and I can't look back for too long. I've got too much to see waiting in front of me. I know that I just can't go wrong. Changes in latitudes, changes in attitudes, nothing remains quite the same. May have been the name of the album, but it was this song right here that put Jimmy Buffett on the map forever. So I'm going to be expecting some help with the salt. Okay, everybody, we're going to have four shakes of salt when we get to the chorus. You know, we're looking for full participation here. We're going to do the Jimmy Buffett National Anthem right now. So, Jimmy, this is for you. You have made many of us very happy and prosperous people because of this song right here. living on sponge cake, watching the sun bake. All of the tourists all covered with all, strumming my sixth string on my funk swing. The smell of the shrimp and they're beginning to boil. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Are we ready, choir? Searching for my lost shaker. Salt, you go.
Salt, salt, salt.
Some people claim that there's a warm on the plane, but I know, I think it's all Kelsey's fault. Don't know the reason, stayed here all season. Nothing to show but a brand new tattoo. Said it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. Have a God, you will have a clue. Wasted away in Margaritaville, searching for my lost shaker of
salt.
Some people claim there's a bomb on the plane, but I know now it's all Mike's fault. Shops, checking out Chiquita's down by the shore. They dream about weight loss, wish they could be their own boss. Those 3-day vacations become quite a bore. Wasted away. Some people claim that there's a bomb on the plane, but I think it, I guess it could be my fault. Blew off the flip-flop, stepped on a pop top. I cut my heel, had to cruise on back home. There's booze in the blender, soon it will render frozen concoction that helps me hang on, hang on, hang on. Wasted away again in Margaritaville, searching for my lost shaker. Some people claim there's a bomb on the plane, but I know it's my own damn fault. Yes, and some people claim there's a bomb on the plane. Always is, and I know it's my own damn fault. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
I got to leave at 5 o'clock somewhere in the clubhouse.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, Mike, we're going to miss you. Everybody say goodbye to Mike. Goodbye, Mike.
So.
Everybody survived the margaritas? Is that good? Yeah. So that was the Changes in Latitudes album, and now my eyes are starting to get all weak here. 1978. We're going to move ahead. From 1977, then came 1978, and an album came out called Son of a Son of a Sailor. And here's that song from that album right now. Came off of that album. That was the same album where they had that great song about cheeseburgers. Do we have cheeseburger fans out there? Do you like yours with lettuce and tomato? Heinz 57 and a French fried potato? Big kosher pickle and a cold draft beer? So good God Almighty, which way do I steer? Tried to amend my carnivorous habits. Made it nearly 70 days. Losing weight without speed, eating sunflower seeds. Drinking lots of carrot juice, soaking up grapes. Thought I'd had this dangerous dream. Some kind of sensuous treat. Be nice. just you. Cheeseburgers and thank you very much. I appreciate that. That's one of those songs I wished I'd have written. But Jimmy wrote it, so, you know. Man, you know, if I'd have written that song, I'd be playing here for free. But I didn't, so I'm not. But it's just a thought that counts. So, I'm keeping an eye on my time here. I've got a whole lot more songs here to go through. And a whole lot less time than to get through them all. So I'm going to have to truncate my list a little bit. But I would like to do this. This song was written. Jimmy was, the cool thing about Jimmy was that Jimmy promoted singer-songwriters. And through his popularity, brought the attention of a lot of obscure singer-songwriters an audience that they would otherwise have never had. And the cool thing that I've always loved about the Parrothead community is that they encourage that same thing. They're very supportive of the songwriting of the people that play Buffett tunes. And it's a really cool legacy that Jimmy Buffett created, and it carries on through the people that followed him. So one of the guys that you probably never would have heard of otherwise was a gentleman by the name of Keith Sykes. And so I'm going to play the song that he did. He did this song on Son of a Sailor album. And then I'm going to play the song that you guys will all recognize that he played, that he wrote for Jimmy on the next album. But this song is called Coast to Marseille. And the thoughts went by like a breeze through my head. How could it be to feel you again? How could it be to feel that way again? Said, how could it be to feel that way again? Remembering me, I ask that question time and again. The answer came and haunted me so. I would not want to think it again. Said I would not want to think it again. You make it so hard to forget. That song was written by Mr. Keith Sykes. Jimmy recorded that on the Son of a Sailor album, and then he wrote the title track to the next album. That one in 1979, and this song's called Volcano. Fun. So also on that album, and I know you guys have been waiting for this, we know what these are, right? Do we have any fins out there? If you feel so inclined, when we get to the chorus, we'll be doing fins to the left and then fins to the right, and we'll take it from there. But this was 1979 on the album Volcano. Thank you. rolling the sand with a rock and roll man somewhere down by the Rhine. Now the money's still good in season. Helps to lighten up the load. Let's keep her high as the months go by. She's getting postcards from the road. Can't you see them closing in, honey? Can't you see them schooling around? Fins up. You got fins to the left, fins to the right, and you're the only bait in town. Sail off to Antigua, take 3 days on a boat for some peace and quiet. Helps to keep her dreams afloat. Now she's like Garamora, and the school's still close at hand. Just behind the reef of the big right, one of the sharks that swim on the land. Can't you see them closing in, honey? Can't you see a school in? How about a hand for the rhythm section up top? The three ladies moving back and forth in time. That was it, just the way we rehearsed it, ladies. That was perfect. So, okay, let's see. Let me get my eyes on here. So we've only made it now up to 1983, and I've got 10 minutes left. So I've got to spin through some tunes. I'll tell you what, we'll do this by audience desire. I've got one particular harbor. We have is that a keeper? We got to get that one in, okay? And then I've got Brown Eyed Girl, which is actually a Van Morrison song. But we got to do Brown Eyed Girl. Right? Okay. And then I'm thinking we skip ahead to Alan Jackson and we close with 5 o'clock somewhere. Would that work? And then we'll just have to do this another time and we'll get these other years in. Because, you know, we go all the way up to 2011 and I'm working on it. I don't know it yet, but I'm working on it. I want to do All Night Long, the version that he did I can picture him. You talk and then it just goes away, you know?
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, exactly. But anyway, hopefully one of these times I come back here, I'll have a version of All Night Long for you, because man, I can picture him. He's right there in my mind, and I can't. And the name is over here, and I can't see that over here. So, but I think where we were going was we were definitely going down to one particular harbor. So, if you need a brush up on your Tahitian, okay, it's Yara Te Natura. Oreja Teane, all right? Prescribed. Used to stuff I can't explain the likes of me. But there's this one particular harbor, far but yet so near, where I see the days as they fade away. Sunshine. In my younger days, I was so bad, laughing about all the fun we had. Sing enough to see the world spin, mixing different runs to meet cousins. Listen to the drummers and the night sound. Listen to the music make the world go round. Takes you right down to the islands, man. But this one's out. This one's for all the brown-eyed girls out there. Hey, where did we go? Days when the rains came. Down in the hollow. Playing a new game. Skipping and jumping in the misty morning fog. Oh, you know the hearts get thumping with you, my brown-eyed girl. You, my brown-eyed girl. So whatever happened 2 days oh so slow, the old mine with a transistor radio, standing in the sunlight, laughing, hiding behind the rainbow's wall, slipping and sliding all along the waterfalls. It was you, a brown-eyed girl. You, my brown-eyed girl. sing, we used to sing. Sha la 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 la. Did I? You got it. So hard to find my way, now that I'm on my own. Thought about it just the other day, my God, you know, baby, you have grown. Cast my memory back and Lord, sometimes I just overcome thinking about it. Making love in the green grass, behind the stadium, it was you. Girl, you my brown-eyed girl. Do you remember when? Here we go again. We used to sing, sha la 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 la. Did I? You guys got it. Very good. Once again, the rhythm section up top. You guys are doing great, man. You want to go on the road? I mean, like, you know, we'll get a bus. You know, we'll get the bus out, take the seats out and stuff, so we can drive. You can drive. I want to sleep. I'll sleep in the back. All right, and then we'll do Stuckey's on the Turnpike. We won't get paid much, but we'll get fed well. So yeah. So. Yes, it's ethereal. It's like the ethereal ooze coming down from upstairs. Right up there. Yes, then how about a hand for the rhythm section up top? So, if you guys have enjoyed yourselves, I got one more song for you. So, if you guys have enjoyed yourselves this afternoon, my name is Mark James. And if you didn't, it's Alan Jackson. So, But we're going to skip ahead right now to 2003. And Alan Jackson wrote a song. He decided it would be good to have Jimmy Buffett on this song. And it turned out this was a very huge turning point in Jimmy Buffett's career. Just a little bit of background on stuff that things that happened with Jimmy. As many of you recall, how many people went to Jimmy Buffett concerts? We have you guys that have been to Buffett concerts. And in this area, or you guys from out of town or whatever, but okay. I mean, I remember going to see Jimmy used to play at the Man, because that was, you know, the down in Philly, the Man was the size of his crowd. But the whole thing about Jimmy Buffett, and few people, the Parrotheads of course knew this, but people in general did not realize that although Jimmy Buffett, The Margaritaville never really made it to number one until like last week or something like that. But through that whole time, Jimmy Buffett and the Grateful Dead were tied for selling out their concerts the fastest out of everybody that was selling concerts at the time. And now, one of the reasons, of course, it's a smaller venue, but I mean, the fact is, Jimmy Buffett fans, just like Grateful Dead fans, as soon as word got out that Jimmy was playing somewhere, they got online, they bought tickets, and Jimmy was sold out. And so, like, Jimmy's concerts were always sold out, but he always played in the smaller venues, like we were saying, like the Man, and, just a cabaret or something like that. But it wasn't until when 5 o'clock Somewhere came out, Alan Jackson had put Jimmy back on the map with 5 o'clock Somewhere. And then it was the following year that Jimmy did "Hey, Good Looking." He redid the Hank Williams tune. And "Hey, Good Looking," he had all Smart move. Jimmy, the consummate entrepreneur, knew to put all of the popular country singers of the time on this one song. And so, of course, he got a Grammy for that. And because you had all these different country singers on there, you had all these different country singers were buying Jimmy Buffett albums. So Jimmy's sales went through the ceiling, the Grammy went through the ceiling, and now finally Jimmy started playing the kinds of venues like JFK, where he was putting 15,000 people in an audience. And so that all actually started because Alan Jackson and 5 o'clock somewhere. So this is a very big turning point for Jimmy Buffett's career, although the man always had money. I remember the big line about Jimmy was like, Jimmy, all you do is you just make something, you know, you have Margaritaville everything, Margaritaville hotels, Margaritaville, you know. He says, hey, if I don't do it, somebody else will. And he said, I came up with it. I'm going to be the one to make the money on it. So I don't know about you, but I think it's always 5 o'clock somewhere. I'd like to say thanks again, Willow Valley, for having me. Slow, so my workday passes like molasses in the winter time. But it's July, getting paid by the hour, over by the minute. My boss just pushed me right over the limit. Like calling something, I think I'll just call it a day. I said, pull me something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I. Only half past 12, but I don't care. What time is it, people? This lunch break is gonna take all afternoon, half night. Tomorrow morning, I know there'll be hell to pay. Jamaican vacation gonna start right here. If the phone's for me, you can tell I just sail away. I said, pull me something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only half past 12, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. He'd say, pour me something tall and strong, make it a big boat drink, I don't want a thing. It's only half past 12, but I don't care. Pour me something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only half past 12, but I don't care. So he don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. I'd like to say once again, thank you very much, Willow Valley. It's been great to play to you guys. You've been singing along, clapping along. Give yourselves a round of applause, man. Thanks so much. My name is Mark James. You guys take care, and I hope to see you again real soon. Thank you very much. Bye bye. Oh, yeah. Cue the balloons. No animals were harmed in the process of this performance.